Hey, and welcome to Ahrefs Monthly Product Updates. We have 9 updates to introduce this month. Let's start with Brand Radar. First up, TikTok is now indexed in Brand Radar. The video visibility section already covered YouTube, and now TikTok joins the mix, so you can search for brand mentions across popular TikTok videos. We scan video descriptions and transcripts, but only surface the snippets where your brand actually appears, not walls of text you don't need. Both TikTok and YouTube are in beta and available to all paid customers. After beta, they'll move into an add-on at $199 per month. Next, you can also now track Reddit visibility in Google search. We've released a new Reddit in SERP index that shows how visible your brand is across Reddit results ranking in Google. It works similarly to AI visibility, but instead of scanning AI responses, we look at Reddit titles, descriptions, and subreddit names that show up in SERP snippets. Reddit tracking is also free while in beta, and later it'll become part of a broader SERP visibility package that includes Google AI overviews, AI mode, YouTube in SERPs, and more. Moving on to a big one, custom queries. You can now track brand mentions for your own prompts, so you see how AI assistants talk about your brand for the exact questions your buyers ask. Custom queries currently support ChatGPT, Gemini, Perplexity, and Copilot. To use it, attach a saved report to a project, set a tracking frequency, and add custom queries. You can track daily, weekly, or monthly with different frequencies per chatbot. Brand Radar now runs on 2 datasets, the global Ahrefs dataset and your project-level custom queries. Reports can show both, or you can switch between them using the new dataset filter. Custom queries use checks based on prompt, model, and location. Checks can be included, prepaid, or pay-as-you-go. Track usage in your account settings or add a prepaid package to check out package pricing. Next up, we've cleaned up how prompts look in Brand Radar. Long responses are now collapsed by default, with full details opening in a side panel. We've also added columns for mentioned brands and fav icons for our cited websites, which makes pattern spotting across results much faster. Plus, fav icons show up in other places now, like cited pages and cited domains. Moving on to a small change that makes a big difference, a new Your Brand Quick Filter. You can now include or exclude your own brand from mentions and citations in AI visibility reports with one click, so you can separate brand-led visibility from competitor or category noise. Moving on to web analytics, you can now analyze trends without losing historical context by importing historical Google Analytics data. If your Google account is linked to a project, you'll pull in GA data from before native web analytics tracking started, so your reports don't begin at zero. Not every GA metric is supported. Anything excluded is marked with an asterisk and a tooltip, so there are no surprises. Moving on to Report Builder. We've revamped Brand Radar widgets. You can now chart additional AI visibility metrics, including citations, impressions, and AI share of voice, not just mentions. We've also moved platform and metric selection directly into widget settings. Combined with widget duplication, this makes it much quicker to spin up multiple views without redoing settings each time. Moving on to Site Explorer. The intent history graph in the overview now includes organic traffic by intent, with traffic being the default view. That means you're not just seeing where keywords rank, but whether those intents are actually bringing visits. Next up is Site Explorer. There's a new page type column in the SERP overview report that uses AI to show what kind of content ranks, like articles, landing pages, or tools, with subtypes such as how-to, listicle, or product pages. This makes it much easier to see what Google rewards for any SERP at a glance. It's available across Site Explorer, Keywords Explorer, and Rank Tracker. Moving on to Social Media Manager, you can now see how your posts perform inside Social Media Manager itself. Every published post now shows engagement metrics like views, reactions, and channel-specific signals all in one place. We've also added historical backfilling and post sync, so you see a complete performance baseline, not a partial story. When you connect a channel, we pull in past posts automatically, including ones published before Social Media Manager was connected or posted directly on the platform. Together, this gives you a full picture of how a channel is performing over time, not just what was scheduled in Ahrefs, and sets the foundation for deeper analytics. Moving on to 2 API updates. We've added more Brand Radar API endpoints, including mentions distribution across AI clients and time series endpoints for mentions and impressions with all the same filters as the UI. We've also upgraded the Site Audit Projects API. You can now pull historical crawl data, query individual projects, support always-on audits, and access richer metrics like URL counts, errors, warnings, and notices, not just health score. Links to docs in description below. And we are done for today. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them on our Kenny. See you in the next update and have a great day.